Cinematography is one of the most essential parts of crafting a film. One could argue it probably is the most essential part of crafting a film. Because without the iris of a lens and the body of a camera, there is no film. With that being said, cinematography allows an avenue of communication that isn't just through the screenplay or on-screen chemistry, but can communicate visually, allowing a secret perspective to a film. Today, we're looking at Badlands. From its wide shot selection, the film is able to convey another narrative through its rich, vibrant color edit and mesmerizing sets. A narrative that is able to paint the American portrait.
Been in all the headlines.
What's that?
You've been fired. Ain't that a hell of a note?
Yeah, how about that? Oh, I don't need my keys anymore. I'll just leave them with them in nice and handy.
I've got my dog.
In Badlands, our main character is a rebel named Kit. Though it's pretty obvious that he's a rebel, this is obviously exemplified by the obvious visual resemblance he shares with James Dean. Throughout the film, Kit races through the American lands, running from any authority that could apprehend his liberation. When he does so, the film is able to convey this narrative by frequently filming those scenes in a wide open landscape. And goodness gracious, this film looks phenomenal. I mean, just look at what's going on right here. It looks absolutely beautiful. Now this is pretty cool. As the story progresses, Kit and Holly continue traveling through the amber waves of grain, the purple majesties, America, America. These shots are meant to illustrate their form of liberation and freedom. Being put in an open field is always, it's always a sign of freedom. Cue Sound of Music. Now, as a viewer and an audience member, we closely associate ourselves with this because Kit is living out the American dream. The American dream that is being to be able to break free from choices and boundaries that constrain us, and then we can pursue our own desires. Doing so, we will be able to fulfill ourselves as people and bring the ultimate pursuit of happiness. It's pretty crafty, not gonna lie, but Malick is able to pull it off. Because maybe you didn't, but some of you started cheering for old Kit, didn't you? It's not like he killed people or anything.
Hey, where you going? Hey.
What's interesting is audiences definitely have a tendency to cheer for the bad guys. And I find that some of the best films are able to have their audiences do exactly that.
Say hello to my little friend!
Now, that's not a bad thing at all, it's just what films do best. Films are at their best when they take you from the world you're in and placing you in another. Science fiction obviously is able to do this, but I'm not just talking about being placed in another different geographical location. In fact, no. Being able to be placed in another human body, another human mind, another human subconscious through the excellence of storytelling. That's what a film can do, and great films do exactly that. I'll tell you why Badlands is pretty clever at doing this through cinematography. Let's take a look at the beginning of the film. This is where we find Kit and Holly, what I like to call the rise of suburb America. But let's take a look at the setting and the scene, because sometimes great cinematography isn't just beautiful images. It's in fact carefully and intentionally placing your characters in places that can mean something. Take a look at this scene. Suburb America can be defined as congested and convoluted. Architecturally, this frame looks tense. Let's take a closer look. On the left-hand side, there's a lot of vertical lines going on, and they seem to be closing in on our character on the backside of Holly. And if we look to the right, there's more vertical lines closing in on Kit's side. This can easily represent that the setting and mood is constraining and restricting our character's freedom. This is another film technique. Placing your characters in a setting that is closing in on them creates a feeling of uneasiness and discomfort. What's the other side of this? Well, it's later in the film. Remember those beautiful shots we referenced earlier? Beautiful, I know. Yes, but architecturally, They are serving a purpose. Because look at this shot right here, later on in the film. Because right here, the architectural makeup of this scene is primarily horizontal, creating a feeling of peace and tranquility. Even when you put both these scenes together, you'll see the obvious difference in how the scene is set, but also the color palette. This feeling of indifference is symbolized even further when Kit and Holly leave the suburbs by burning down Holly's home and running into their freedom. I'm telling you, it's absolutely genius what they were able to do with this film. I mentioned this film paints a portrait of America, and again, it's because of this beautifully crafted, intentional cinematography. Remember, the wide shots are intentional, but they're absolutely mesmerizing. For a moment, it can feel like Malick is falling too much in love with his craftsmanship and the scenery that was before him. Because many said that Badlands production was actually known for that. And to be honest, I do believe Malick does fall too much in love with his work and sacrifices a bit of character and story. But isn't that the perfect portrait of America? Don't we fall too much in love with the look of someone or something rather than investing in the actual character of it? Best example of this is at the end of the film when Kit is caught and arrested. He is by all means a definition a prisoner of the law now, but they don't treat him like one, do they? No, in fact, he is celebrated like a celebrity. Never mind the 11 that were shot, but even the officers were not too interested in the actual character of Kit, but they were infatuated by his resemblance to James Dean.
You know who that sumbitch looks like? You know, don't you?
No.
I'd kiss your ass if you don't look like James Dean.
Badlands is a beautiful, moving portrait with astonishing scenes that look like they were painted. But more than looking like one, director Terrence Malick and his cinematographers worked intentionally to craft a modern portrait of 1973 America. But it's so interesting because it's still relevant to the modern America that we are living in. This wasn't done so much through the dialogue cut in between the actors or even the editing on the floor. Rather, it was the secret character we sense was speaking, but had yet to make an appearance. The cinematography. You're